Hi students, welcome to BioBeam channel. Today we are going to discuss about class 10th NCERT science, chapter number 6, life process. So let us first understand what is the important characters of living things. So how we can differentiate living things and non-living things? We take the examples of the dog running, the cow chewing the curd, and a man shouting loudly. We say they are all living organisms. But when we take the dog or the cow or the man who is sleeping, then how can we say they are living? But still, by taking an important character, breathing, we say they are living organisms. What about plants? We say living organism because they are green in color. Then what about the plants which are having the color other than green? Then we take growth over a period of time is an important character of living organism. Then movement is also one of the important character of living organisms. We say there are invisible molecular movement in the organism. Is this necessary for the life? When you ask to the biologists, they say, yes, it is required. Then in viruses, you cannot see this invisible molecular movement unless the virus infects the cell. Because of that, there is a controversy that whether viruses are living or non-living. When we come to the organization of the living organism, you can see the body is made up of organs. In turn, they are made up of tissues. In turn, they are made up of cells. And cells contain different types of molecules. And this organization is always continuously affected by external environment. So due to this external environment, there is a breakage of this order. And this breaking over time will make the organism to die. So to maintain this, to repair and maintain the living organisms require continuous movement of molecules. And this movement of molecules will help the repairing and maintenance of living organisms. And let us study what are the different types of life process which helps in repairing and maintaining the structures of living organisms. What are the different types of life process? So let us study in detail. So here, all organisms require energy. Energy to do work. So this energy requirement is fulfilled by obtaining food outside the body. So this food is mainly depend upon the carbon based. And so all organisms require food which contain carbon. So the different mode of obtaining food or the different type of mode of obtaining food is called nutrition. Then in the body, there will be different chemical reactions which are going on. We commonly say as oxidation and reduction reactions. Oxidizing and reducing or oxidation reduction reactions. These reactions require oxygen to break down the food molecules. And after breakdown of food molecules, there will be energy released. And that process is called respiration. Then coming to single-celled organisms, they don't have specific organ in the body to take the food, exchange of gases or removal of waste. As they are made up of single cell, the body of the organism obtain food or remove food which is waste by simple diffusion. And we know diffusion is the movement of molecules or ions from the region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration. if there is more waste inside the body, it will go outside. If there is food more outside, it will go inside, like that diffusion. Multicellular organisms, their body or their cells are not directly exposed to the environment. So for that purpose, they need a specific system to obtain the food or to remove the waste or other mechanisms. So the cells are not in direct contact with the surrounding environment. Coming to the chemical reactions, use carbon source, oxygen, and these create a byproducts which are waste. They are useless and harmful. They should be removed from the body. So after chemical reactions in the body, they should be, the waste should be removed outside. This removing of the waste is done by excretion. So we have four types here. One is nutrition, that is mode of obtaining food. The respiration, where energy is released or exchange of gases takes place. The another is transportation. Transportation, where the food which is taken inside is supplied to all parts of the body. And the last one is the excretion, where the waste is removed. So totally there are four types of life process: nutrition, respiration, transportation, and excretion. These four important life processes will be discussed in the future videos.